are you off to, Crystal? Church? Lord knows you love to get down on your knees.
Okay, we're done here.
Yes, get back to work, you company tramp. Or is it company slut? Yep. Which do you prefer? You know, you may have married into money, but you are still nothing more than a well-paid whore!
That's not what people are talking about, is it? They're talking about your ass, and that just makes it harder for all of us. I mean, I can't believe I'm saying this, but at least if Fallon had gotten the job, no one would have accused her of sleeping her way there.
So you're down with nepotism?
Not at all. But at least that only reflects badly on Blake. Not an entire gender.
This is about women in business.
Oh, well, I just figured since you were here, this must be penthouse. My bad. You know you don't have a chance at this, right? They're trying to sell magazines. If you were a real businesswoman, you'd know that.
A great afternoon, wouldn't you say, Fallon?
Well, it's hard to believe it topped your morning. Word on the street is that Claudia Blaisdell stopped by the office for a little rant and rave session.
That's none of your concern, Fallon.
Oh, I didn't say I was concerned, Daddy. Well, everything in moderation, especially family bonding. Anyway, I'll be sure to tell him you're trying your best. Even though your freshest idea today came from somebody else. But there's always next year. If you're still around.
I don't think you'll be needing those.
I like to be prepared.
Well, let me guess, you were a Girl Scout? You won't be getting the merit badge today.
Best of luck to you, Fallon.
Oh, I don't believe in luck. I believe in opportunity. And this is one I had no intention of letting slip by. You know, I had to sacrifice a lot to get where I am. Nothing was ever handed to me. I worked my way from the ground up. I made things happen. I didn't just stumble into a COO job. I created opportunities for myself. I've recently started my own company, Morel Green Energy Corp, which I am building from the ground up on my own. I did you a favor. Now people will think you failed as COO because of the tape, not because you're useless at your job.
In fact, let me be the first to toast Fallon Carrington on her big achievement. Congratulations.
It's a big company. People talk. And women will never break through the glass ceiling if they're always looking for a shard to stab each other in the back.
Clever capture.
Your father taught me well.
He always has been able to see multiple moves ahead. I thought I had inherited that skill set.
My husband is dead! You don't get to feel better about yourself now, Crystal Carrington! You are gonna pay for the pain that you caused!
Steven, you look so handsome. Though you do look a little pale. Have you had your vitamin D tested?
Never mind the years of therapy for abandonment issues. How is your vitamin D?
Fallon, I'm glad to see that your father had your teeth fixed, if not your tongue.
What the f-?
And who is this? He's adorable. What's his name?
Crystal. Oh my God, Crystal. I didn't realize the coincidence until I said it out loud. Can you believe it?
No, I can't. It's an interesting name for a male dog.
Sometimes a name just screams out at you.
He was a rescue, trashy little thing.
Desperate. Practically ate garbage out of my hand. Stinky little freeloader, aren't you, Crystal? Yes, you are. Oh, yes, you are.
Hey, how are you holding up?
Don't you want to wait 11 years to ask me that? Apparently that's what this family does.
It's a good thing you don't consider me family, then.
Where the hell is she?
What's the matter? Why are you so...
You are unbelievable. I have caught you red-handed and you're doubling down on more lies.
How dare you call your mother a liar?
You don't even know me.
How could I? I'm not the child you chose to stay in touch with. You know, for a split second, you actually had me believing that you cared, but you don't care about anybody but yourself. What kind of horrible woman abandons their daughter?
That's not true. My feelings for my children are completely genuine.
Nothing about you is genuine.
Okay, I better break this up before someone drowns.
Don't you dare.
You were never a mother to us.
As if anyone could mother you. You are born an egomaniac.
Like mother, like daughter. You may remember this. A little gift Mommy Dearest sent to me for my sweet 16. Why? So you can feed me more of your lies? You want the house? Fine.
Take it. But if you think we're gonna be one big happy family here, I have news for you. I will never, ever! Live under the same roof as you again.
You son of a bitch! You're not gonna get away with this, Blake Carrington!
After all, it's the least I deserve, considering he stole the rest of the estate.
He didn't take anything from you. I did. But Daddy was wrong, banishing you from our lives. Someone like you needs to be destroyed.
I assume none of these are from you.
What do I have to apologize for?
I don't know. Stealing my job?
I told you, I had no idea he was going to offer it to me.
Didn't stop you from taking it.
You would have done the same if you were in my position. Oh, that's right. You did.
It's not much, but it's all they had left after some fool brought out the rest of the shop.
Well, I'm glad you helped someone else keep their job today.
I plead guilty for all high crimes and misdemeanors of which I stand charged, Your Honor.
Not the crap, Blake.
Blake gives up too easily. Case in point, me, and accepts too little. Case in point, you.
Well, you seem like a part-time hoarder. Where might I find some of these documents?
Gee, I don't remember exactly. Of course, I bet if I wasn't locked up here, it would help jog my memory.
A negotiation.
Mm-hmm.
Now that's the kind of crazy I can appreciate.
Oh, he'll stay on for a while. Trust me, I've taught him well.
Well, of course, I know what it's like to feel your marriage to Blake Carrington dying on the vine. Nowhere to turn, feeling vulnerable and powerless.
I'll never give up my power.
Silly Crystal, you already have. You just don't know it yet.
You were happy then.
We had everything. Beautiful son, new family. I was in love with both my boys.
You're staying in this marriage, whether you want to or not.
You may own half of Georgia, Blake, but you don't own me.
Yes, I do.
Blake's not gonna hand over the reins to CA, so I'm gonna have to take them before he drives that company into the ground and my children end up with nothing.
What do the Colbys have to do with that?
Well, like you, they're owed shares. So together you'll have close to controlling interest.
Facts can't be denied. My father is no longer fit to run this company, and it's your job as Carrington Atlantic's board to make a change. It's time to vote Blake Carrington out and name me as your new CEO.
You wake up, Carrington. You got played by your wife, and now your son's being played by this idiot.
That kiss yesterday, I felt it. So did you.
While you were off, God knows where, in some sort of childish fugue state, I had to be the adult around here, holding this family together.
Yeah, and I needed to figure things out.
Well, I have figured things out. If you care about me at all, you will do this one thing for me.
This one thing? Are you serious? I've spent my life doing things for you, not that you would notice.
You have never done anything that hasn't helped Blake Carrington.
Don't you raise your voice to me. I am still your father.
Then act like one!
So being the thirsty whore that you are, you thought you'd come up here and take what you want.
How dare you call me that?
Well, what do you want? Alexis? What do you really want?
Oh, really? Because not too long ago, I was kidnapped from this joint, and if my memory serves me correctly, it was OG Krystle that had me found because she defied your plan and the police were able to do their job.
If you have seen this woman or know where she is, please contact us immediately. Help me find my grandson.
Our grandson.
I'm gonna kill him. And if she makes it out of Atlanta, then that kid's blood is on your hands.
My hands? How dare you point your finger at me when you were the one that started this whole mess?
Excuse me?
If you hadn't gone to visit Claudia in the psych ward and riled her up, whatever you said to her, she broke out the next day, and then she came here, and then she killed Crystal. You think I have blood on my hands? You certainly have Crystal's blood on yours.
Give me the baby.
No! No, no, you're lying to me!
No, 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 you're so
no,
lying!
No, 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 no!
Why, little guy? Auntie Kirby's gonna take you home.
You woke the baby.
You're the biggest liar of them all, aren't you?
Who is Hank, dear? Another doll of yours?
Where are you taking me? You said you were gonna help me.
And you said you killed my wife. Everyone up there heard it. Look, I am helping you. I'm helping you understand the pain you caused me and my family by taking away what you love. I know it's cruel. He's only a baby. Will it make things equal? I don't know. But it's a hell of a start.
And not that it's all that special. I mean, even worms can procreate.
It's pathetic watching you hold on to your old life long after it ended. Your family is done with you. Stephen left the country to get away from you. Fallon fears turning into you, and Blake only pities you. Your time at the manor is over. And the saddest part is you know it.
I completely understand if you feel your book would be better served elsewhere.
Looks like Ruthless Fallon is back. I'm not quitting. So if you want me gone, cut me a check.
Not possible.
I'm staying on your roster. And you're following through with my press event tonight.
As we were planning to.
Must have been too late to cancel.
Non-refundable deposit.
Don't bother showing up tonight.
Are you kidding? I wouldn't miss it. I'll see you tonight.
And every night.
She doesn't know what she wants.
Really? Well, she certainly did last night.
You watch your mouth.
Ooh. Well, I do hope you enjoy your weekly visits to him and the slammer. Maybe you can be his intern. Bring him his cigarettes, maybe a shiv. Don't touch me.
My father did everything for you!
Fallon, my back is up against the wall here. I'm about to lose everything. I lost Carrington Atlantic because of you. I lost my dad. And then Celia and Stephen. Come and work with me again. This time, we'll build our legacy as a true team, equal partners, creating our dynasty.
It would take me a lifetime to repay you for everything that you've done for me. And I would like the chance to try, if you let me.
I guess there's no question as to which child you should side with now.
Jeff won't be a problem anymore.
Well, I'm glad to hear it.
I assume the payments will resume immediately? Well,
of course, sis. We share the same blood, which means we look out for one another.
Related by blood, yes. But what you and I share is deception, jealousy, and lies.
That's right, Sid and Nancy. I figured it out. But Colhane already got rid of the bag of money, so you won't be getting away with this.
Oh. Wait, did you say bag or bags? Yep, that's what I thought.
Fallon never talked about it. But I think that was one of the things that really screwed me up, you know?
While I'm working to secure a father's future, it might not be best for you to come after me, or I'll come right back after you.
You want to come after me? Bring it on.
Because your lies started a downward spiral for Stephen that led to our divorce and left me with a void in my life and no purpose, which is exactly why this hotel is so important to me right now.
Hey, I'm proud of you for tackling that gardening thing. Path of least resistance is very seductive and you didn't take it.
Why don't you want to confront Adam? Why are you protecting him?
I'm not. It's just...
Just what? What are you hiding?
Yeah, Dom, is this something you'd like to tell us?
Boo.
Won't fight that stupid plaque any longer, and the Alliance is going to list my hotel as the number one must-visit location in Atlanta. If you're going to force me to commemorate a bigot on my property, I'm going to leverage it into enough bookings to pay my bills.
All right? The second Monty called me, I knew you were up to your old tricks again, and I'm not having it. I want you out now.
Give me power, and I promise our dynasty will flourish.
So, battle lines have been drawn. Well, if it's war they want, it's war they'll get.
How sad is this, Blake?
In the past, you would have sent Fallon or Adam to do your dirty work. Clearly, you've alienated yourself from the entire family, because here you are groveling all alone. I understand, though. You alienated me from my family for years. Only I didn't have a choice. You did this to yourself.
I know how much you miss her, Blake.
Don't let your pride stand in the way.
So, what did I do to deserve a summons from Blake Carrington?
Absolutely nothing. Yet.
Hmm.
Thought I'd mix things up for a change. I need a favor from you. You have access to Jeff's house. I need inside, specifically his office. He's trying to buy Carrington Atlantic, and I need to find out whatever I can about his plan. So, can I count on you, sis?
If it's a choice between you and children, I mean, Liam, I choose you.
You really mean that?
Yeah. You see, I'm all about compromise.
Neurotoxicity, is it? And oddly enough, Chlorcite is researching a drug to cure just that. Research that I have put a halt to. I mean, how bad are the symptoms anyway? You look a little shaky.
You think this is over? See, there are plenty of other pharma companies I can buy. But there's only one CA. Victorious. And it will be mine.